OS and short basic UI configuration. Please introduce that I'll be adding this panel. MPC-NA, MPC-W, MPC-TCE, to MPC-IA.
It'll be fine.
Currently, I'm working with PowerNet in Liberia, West Africa, as Technical and Operation Manager since 2015 until now, today. And I'm using Microtik since 2008, and I'm one of the Microtik Forum Administrator in Indonesia. And this forum Microtik is the first Microtik research forum in Asia. And also, I'm a Microtik consultant and networking trainer. Okay, short introduction about PowerNet. PowerNet is ISP in Liberia, West Africa, that's established since 1998, and the first ISP in Liberia who using IPv6, using IPv6 in Liberia, West Africa. We are the largest ISP subscriber in Node.gsm ISP. For Node.gsm ISP, we are the largest ISP subscribers, and we are the first ISP that bring Microtik or introduce Microtik in Liberia, West Africa. And also, we still always introduce people to use Microtik until today. Now we're using Microtik more than 300 devices online, live, like this, you see in the list. And all PowerNet network is managed by Dude, wireless centralized by Capsman, and for the users, authenticated by Userman. We use Radius Manager using Userman. And for core routing, BGP, PPPoE server, until the end users, we using all Microtik product. Okay, now we're going to the switch OS. Most technicians or most people just hear about Microtik router OS, but just few people know about switch OS. What is switch OS? Switch OS is software operating system for Microtik switch. So you cannot use switch OS on other product, only for Microtik switch. Okay, Microtik has two software product. One is Microtik Switch OS, and the other one is Microtik Router OS. Microtik Switch OS used on the switch and only web-based configuration. So if you want to access the Microtik Switch OS, you cannot use webhook. You have to use web configuration. The default IP is the same, standard Microtik 192.168.1.8.1. User admin and no passwords, without passwords. Okay, I don't need to explain about router OS because everybody knows already about router OS. Okay, Microtik switch OS exists until now. They have two versions, version 1.17, and the last version I just checked is 2.7, but this still 2.6. The last version I just checked is 2.7. That's not different, not too different. They just have upgrading some features. Microtik Switch OS only have web configuration. You cannot access by remote, you cannot access by console, you cannot access by terminal, SSH or similar. Microtik Switch OS, SNMP supported, and also support for Microtik Discovery. So if you install Microtik Switch OS in your network, you will see the Microtik Switch on your network. Okay, this is the preview screen for the version 1.17, and this is the version for 2.6 or 2.7. This is 2.6 and 2.7 is not too different. 2.6, 2.7 is not too different. But the difference between 1.17 and 2.6 is the meaning. I will bring back to the previous slide. Sorry. Okay. Microtik have two different hardware for the switch. This version 1.17 or 1.17 only supports for this router board type. 260 or 260 GSP. But for the version 2.6 or 2.7 now, only for CSS family. So if you check the switch, and the switch have code CSS something, so you mean the firmware is the version for 2.6. But if you not see CSS on the hardware, so you mean use the first version. Okay, now I want to bring you inside the configuration. VLAN is one of the features of the Swiss OS. And VLAN configuration on the Swiss OS is under VLAN and VLAN's menu. They have VLAN and VLAN's menu. Okay, this VLAN menu. This VLAN menu on the, sorry. Okay, this VLAN menu on the version 1.17 or 1.17. Very basic. And this is the VLAN menu on 2.6 or 2.7. More detail. Okay? In the VLAN menu, we can manage, we will manage the port configuration, we set up the mode, we set up the VLAN receive, and we set up the VLAN ID, and also the VLAN headers to add, remove, or just lift the VLAN ID or change the VLAN ID. But in the VLANs, please note that this is different. VLANs and VLAN. Sorry, I borrowed the clicker, so I was mistaken. There is VLAN and VLAN is different. If you see closer, this VLAN, come on. If you see closer, this VLAN, and after VLAN, they have VLAN menu. So there is VLAN and VLAN with S and without S. VLAN and VLAN. VLAN to control the port, the interface, to control the interface. VLAN to control or to manage the VLAN ID. So the different VLAN to manage the port, VLAN, you see as, to manage the VLAN ID or VLAN tags. Okay, VLAN menu to manage the VLAN table, to specify certain forwarding rule for packets with VLAN ID. So this not manage the port, but this manage the VLAN ID. What do you want to do with the VLAN ID? What do you want to do with the VLAN that's passing through the switch? This is the screen for the 1.17. And this is the screen for 2.6. The difference 2.6 or 2.7 using checklist, but in 1.17 you see drop box. Just select box. Okay, next. Basic practice or example. This is the example. Okay, the basic practice. Like this screen. Let's say we set up already the core router, and now we just need to set up the microtik switch. One cable from the core router go to the microtik switch on port number 1, Astro. Inside the trunk, they have 3 fill lines. And after microtik switch, the fill line split it to each network. So one cable from core router, let's assume the core router already set up with the trunk and the VLAN, and 3 VLANs will be passing in one cable, in one trunk. After one cable, go to the microtik switch, and microtik switch will divide or will split each VLAN to the each
interface. Okay, this is the example. Port 1 we use as strong. Port 2, 3, and 4 we use as access port or the edge VLAN port. So all the trunk will go to the port number 1 and port number 2, 3, 4 we use as separate VLAN. This is the screen on 1.17, and this how to set up on the 2.6 or 2.7. Okay. What we need to do is we put port number 1 trunk, we select VLAN mode as enable. And then we left the address at if missing or leave as is. This is similar. It's not too important on the ingress, on the trunk port. But this important on the access port 2, 3, 4. This is the access port. It's important because you have to set the VLAN on the port number 2, 3, and 4. The VLAN mode should be strict. Should be strict. With VLAN receive only untagged. Only untagged. So anything traffic that's coming to this port number 2, 3, 4, the switch will be put VLAN ID on the traffic based on the port configuration. And then for egress, I mean egress is the packets going out from the port. The switch will be remove the VLAN ID, and we have to choose this as always trip or remove the VLAN ID. When we select the always trip, I mean no more VLAN ID going out from the interface or from the port. This is how to set up on Switch OS 2.6 or 2.7. We need to decide the VLAN ID, We need to set up the VLAN receive and we select the VLAN mode. Okay, and then on the VLANs table, VLAN using S, VLANs table, we have to add the VLAN ID, which is we use to manage. We will use to manage. In previous screen, we have 10, 20, and 30. So we will make VLAN table 10, 20, and 30. And then we select the member, the interface member. The interface member, the first is interface 1, interface 2, interface 3, and then go behind. So interface 1 as strong. So we have to select all interface 1 as active. And interface 2 only for VLAN 10. Interface 3 only for VLAN 20. Interface 4 only for VLAN 30. So this based on the configuration in previous menu or in the VLAN menu. So this VLAN menu should be same with configuration on the VLANs table. Okay, and this is the screen for the VLAN table on 117. It's not checklist, but selecting box. We left this as strong. We open this as always strip. For interface that not related with that VLAN ID, we have to select as not a member. Not a member is mean not checklist on here. And then after we finish set up this, apply, the switch will be works as VLAN manage, to manage the VLAN 10, 20, and 30. Okay, this is how the basic configuration for VLAN. Beside the VLAN features, we have another features for Microtik switch. We can use as isolation, forwarding, mirror, link aggregation, etc. Also, the Microtik switch have PoE port output, and they have new product too. And this Microtik switch, we can use to extend the physical interface. Let's say your router only have 5 ports, and you need more physical interface. You can use Microtik switch as extended interface. Activate as strong, and from the strong, you can make as VLAN. And one of the feature is isolation port. Isolation port will control the port forwarding, prevent from broadcast loop. So this is the difference from the ordinary switch and manageable switch. Manageable switch, we can manage the control from for forwarding and to prevent from broadcast loop. The ordinary switch cannot manage the broadcast loop. And prevent from unwanted crossing traffic, that's from port to port, that's not authorized, you can block from there. And secure network from the netcat, Wireshark, and etc. The latest version of SwitchOS coming with RSTP. And isolation port menu. This, what I mentioned here is this for 2.6. Yeah, 2.6. 2.6 have RSTP and port isolation. But in version 1.17, they don't have RSTP and don't have isolation. The installation we manage in forwarding menu. We can also use the installation port as port grouping. Installation port will not block remote access. You will still have access. You are still able to access the switch even you activate the installation port. Installation port just manage or block the traffic between port to another port, but it's not block your access remote to the switch itself. This is the port installation. You can select which one port can talk with each other. Let's say example this. This is the example. This port number one. This port number one. This port number two, number two, this port number two. This port number two and this port number two. So when we select, port number two active on port number one, it means port number one can listen port number two. And then if we select port number one on port number two, it means port number two can listen port number one. So this port number one and number two is talk each other because we select to active or not isolated. But when you uncheck, it mean isolated. This port will not hear the port unchecked on the screen. And this how to set up on older switch OS on 1.17 on forwarding menu. And the rule is the same. Check it mean listen, uncheck it mean will not listen. So when we select like this, port number one, check port number four. It mean port number one will listen anything coming from port number four, will forward the packet. And port number four, check port number one. Also port number four will listening from port number one, will forwarding each other. But port number two will not talk with port number three because port number two not open or not listening port number three. Also port number three not listening port number two. Okay, that's my short presentation. Sorry if anything too fast for you. If any have question, please ask question. If no question, I will call Microtik back to the stage. Okay, no question. Thank you. You can download the presentation on the Microtik website, or you can come to me to get the PDF. Thank you so much.